That camera's going for a spin this morning.
Yes.
Okay, good morning, everybody. We have such an amazing story.
Yeah.
An inspiring story to all the little kids out there. If you think, oh, I can't wait to be a big person to do big people things. Remember when you used to be like, don't you remember that?
Yeah. And you play guns as a kid,
yeah.
play toy soldiers and all that.
Yeah, but sometimes you learn if you don't like something, speak up.
Yes.
Yeah.
So little Vivian, 6 years young, wrote this letter saying, my name is Vivian. I play soccer. I'm 6 years old. Why do you not make girl army men, those little green toys?
Yeah.
She said, my friend's mom is in the army too. I saw the pink ones, but those aren't girls, and people in the army don't wear pink.
True.
Some girls don't like pink.
Fair.
So please, can you make army girls that look like women? I would play with them every day, and my friends would too. Thank you, Vivian. Well, guess what? The
BMC
toy company
toys.
Noticed.
Said, yeah, we like your idea, and I think we're going to do it.
They're going to do it.
That is awesome.
Her.
Yeah, she sent it to three different companies.
Yep.
And this BMC one responded. Yeah, and they said that they were looking at concept ideas and putting them out there. And I think it's great.
But concept ideas, really, what is the concept of? You just do a female version of the soldiers, the little toy soldiers.
Yeah.
Right.
There's not a lot of thinking to it. Just do it.
Did you guys have that set growing
up?
Oh, yeah. The little green soldiers?
Yeah, my boys did too. There's like a big kind of brown thing, you get full of them, hundreds
like
and hundreds.
A barrel of them.
And I think we all went through that. My son went the same thing. We loved it.
Yeah.
And it's great. It's great to see them added in.
Yeah.
Hopefully they'll be in soon.
She knows a female who's in the Army, so she's like, where's the representation?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And women have been in the Army for a good long time.
Mm-hmm.
So why wouldn't there be that set? And it's long overdue. And I love that they actually responded and they're working on it because they got to go back to the drawing board, figure out, you know, the molds.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not that hard to make the mold.
Sure.
I mean, just redo it. But it's great. And sometimes, though, you know what it does? It takes. One, the suggestion to get people thinking about it. It's like it gets put away so far away that people don't think about it. And sometimes you need one little girl to go, hey,
just
why aren't
up.
You doing this? And they're like, you're right.
Yeah.
Break the mold.
Yeah.
And you can have that power even if you are 6 years old. That's what we're learning from that. And I know you always do that with your sons, Frankie. You're like, speak up. Something's not right.
And question things.
Yes.
You know, that's the biggest thing. If something doesn't make sense to you, ask the question, why is it not that way?
Yeah.
And then if you don't like the answer, then go change the answer.
Yeah, and if someone doesn't want to give you an answer, find someone who will give you the answer. Right?
Resilience.
That's the worst with kids sometimes is we just ignore their questions or we don't answer them. It's like, no, they want to. If you tell them the answer, they're usually pretty happy with that.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to give them an answer and a proper answer. And you want to see them pursue things like that. It's great.
And you're right about that. I mean, I don't have any kids, but being around kids a lot, you know, working at camps and things like that, when a kid would ask me a question, if I didn't know the answer, so as a parent or a grown-up, say you don't know and help them find the answer instead of giving them some kind of fluff or, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And they're just like, oh, I didn't
because
get anything out of that.
They know when you're lying to them.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Or they will find out later and resent you for it.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, Gavin's going to grade 8 this year.
Yeah. Oh, wow, already.
I'm not looking forward to grade 8 math.
Yeah,
I won't know a lot of the answers.
Same.
You can do it. Start brushing up now, Frank. Start brushing up now.
Yeah. Oh, grade 8 already, Frankie.
Grade 8.
My
big
gosh,
years.
Where does the time go?
Ken's going to grade 7.
He's going into grade 7 this year. Now, he stays in the same school. Oh, no, he would have jumped last year. Did he jump last year?
No, there's no middle school where we are.
Yeah. I remember that. That was the big transition, though, going to grade 7, because you went to a different school, different direction.
Is that right?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. I went from Bala, shout out to Bala, and to C.R. Marchand. Shout out to C.R. Marchand.
So you were in your own school for grade 7 and 8?
A different school, yeah, only two grades there. They wanted it as a transition between grade school and high school.
Interesting.
I just remember being so young and saying, I can't wait to reach up. We used to have phones on our walls. I know people don't have that. And I was like, I can't wait when I can grab that phone on the wall and be tall enough. And then I turned 6.
Weren't you? I was going to say, weren't you always tall enough? I still can't reach that phone.
And then I turned 6.
Yeah.
Time is 8 o'clock. You're watching BT. You are perfect as you are, Devo Brown.
Thanks.
Call us.